Thank you very much again. So I would like to invite my second speaker, my good friend, Pak Holisul Fatikin. He's also doing the same thing. He's inspiring another Indahiyat paper factory to be certified. But still, the first guy can always claim that I'm the first guy, right? Please, Pak Holisul, time is yours. Another 25 minutes, Pak Holisul, please.
Thank you, Pak Aris. Pak Aris is my teacher. He teaches me and other company to implement energy management system and steam system optimization or system optimization. Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the opportunity to present today. My name is Holisul Fatihin. I'm from Indahiyat, Tangerang. Today I will present the experience of Indahiyat Tangerang during the implementation of energy management system. This is a short description of the company. I just put a little information in here. If you need more information, maybe you can ask to Uncle Google, please. Thank you. So Indahiyat Tangerang founded in 1976, 40 years ago, by Mr. Supapo. And now PT Indahiyat is subsidiary of Sinarmas Group, ASEAN Pulp and Paper Group. Today Indahiyat Tangerang is one of biggest company that produce colored paper, specialty paper. So 2006 we start to produce the colored paper. This is our product. From the finishing product like the roll and the big sheet and the converted product like this, some envelope or tokoro and other, we supply or send this product, sell the product to the market Japan as well. So the highest standard quality market in the world. Yeah. So we sell our product to Japan as well. This is a mass energy conservation activity in our mill, Tangerang Mill. Long ago, in 1991, we already implement some project that modified the boiler. Before we use a diesel oil and we change or modify the burner. So after that, we use a gas to run or to operate the boiler. And next year, in 1995, we install cogeneration, the gas turbine, to replace the diesel engine. You take the gas as well. And in 1996, we implement an environmental management system, ISO 14001. This is the first company in the South Asia that implement this environmental management system. And for the sustainability, we install the coal fire boiler. So we have source, the energy source like gas and diesel and then the coal to diversification of energy. And another project designed for the this, we have some project that to improve the machine efficiency, like install the inverter or replace the V-bell, etc. And after that, what's next we have to do? So we think that we have to integrate the energy efficiency activity into day-to-day operation control. So we decided to implement energy management system, and in 2012 we start to implement ISO 50001, and we get certified in November 2013. So why we choose this standard? Because this is an international standard. So maybe we can improve our image in the worldwide, and the system is guidance for us to implement the energy management system that uses a systematical approach and of the top management. So to implement this standard, so the top management should have commitment for this and involve all employees in the company, and we have support and they have a tangible benefit for this management standard. I will explain one by one for the this management. From the first is energy policy, that this is our commitment of our management, and second is for energy planning implementation, then checking and management review. So the commitment management is very, very important to implement this standard. So the top management has to commit to improvement, energy improvement continually, and top management has to commit give resources, availability, information, and resources to achieve objective and target. This is the commitment have to declare of from the top management, and top management have to support the purchase of energy efficiency product, have to comply with applicable legal requirement and other requirement. So this is the commitment we already declared, our management act declared. We have a energy policy. We combine the policy become a common policy. So all the energy management system we put together in here. So the policy including the quality management system and environmental management system and the energy management system. So we integrated all in one policy, company policy. So then we have a energy management team to drive the system, and we set the role and responsibility of the team. Second is the planning, energy planning. This is the energy planning process. Start from the analyze energy use and consumption, and identify area significant of energy use and consumption, and then identify opportunity for improving the energy. The input of this process is the past or present data of the energy consumption, and the output is we have to decide energy baseline, energy performance indicator, objective target, and the action plan. First, after we analyze our energy consumption and uses, we found that the significant energy use is in this area, stock preparation and the paper machine. This is most or significant energy consumption. This is our process. Actually now, the PT Indah Kiat Tangerang don't have the power plant. So the power plant is already take over by sister company. So the scope and of the our implementation is in this area. So start from the stock preparation. There are some process in here, some machinery in here, and then going to the paper machine. So the challenging for us is that mainly the equipment of our mill is just motor, yeah, this motor and pump. So very, very difficult to improve the energy efficiency, because there are no many manner. Just replace the motor with the high efficiency motor or install the inverter. In the power plant, maybe we have many opportunity to improve, yeah, in the steam system here. But in the plant, in our plant is very, very difficult after we do some improvement. So the critical point in this process energy planning is decided the energy performance indicator. Actually, there are some way to develop the energy performance indicator. There are three. One is absolute consumption. Yeah. So for example, last year we consume energy 100,000. And this year, maybe we have to reduce maybe 90,000 consumption. But in the absolute consumption, in the industry, it's very, very difficult to see the performance. Sometimes, the last year, the consumption is 100,000 kilowatts. But after we do improvement, we install inverter ASEAN, the consumption increase become, for example, 110,000. Yeah. So management maybe blame the team. Why? Because maybe we don't consider the driver. So maybe for the first energy performance indicator, absolute maybe not available in the industry. Second, we can use the specific energy consumption like kilowatt per ton paper or kilowatt per ton product. But sometimes, okay, maybe this is again misleading. Because of the market situation is not good, yeah, the utility, yeah, utilities of machine is drop, then the specific energy consumption going up, it's not improved anymore. For example, before 600 kilowatt per ton paper, after improvement become 650 maybe kilowatt per ton paper. Nothing wrong with the team, but because of the production is decreased because of market situation, for example. So the another why is using the regression formula like this. So in that case, we use this, but maybe we can test that improvement using this formula. So we can compare the prediction, energy prediction, and actual energy consumption. Next, we can expand. Another project we do, that is the steam system optimization. Yeah, we learn from the Paris for the steam optimization. This is a paper machine. So the paper, the wet paper come from here. This is a wet paper, 80% water, 20% is fiber. Yeah. So we need some energy to drive the wet paper from here going to this heat. This is the pop rail. So we need a steam to drive the wet paper in here. So we need electricity and we need a steam in the paper machine area. So we do the optimization in the paper machine. This is a dryer, we call a dryer. This is a dryer cylinder. You can see from here. So the steam inject to the dryer, the saturated steam inject to the dryer. And after going to the inside, the steam become water, condensed, become water here. So if we not move the water from the dryer, the water become a ring like this, the ring water, water ring. The water like this make a energy or the heater cannot going to the outside because the water ring in here. So we have to evacuate the water inside the dryer using this pipe. There is no pumping. This is using the differential pressure to evacuate the water from the dryer. So we have to set the differential pressure and we have to set the gap of the pipe in here. If the gap is too big, and then the consumption, steam consumption is control all equipment using the computer in here. Another project that we already done, the simple project like make a machine stop during idle time, the roller stop during the time, or we replace the V-bell using timing bell, or we replace the line shaft before using a line shaft, become a sectional drive, and we doing the monitoring using the DCS so the operator can see the energy consumption in the DCS monitor. And another incentive that we involve our employees. So we have some like the same barai. So there are some improvement activity like the small group activity, that's the internal activity, not cross-functional. Cross-functional is self-development activity, and we have the employee such as the system, and we implement total productive maintenance for our team. The next step is checking. We doing internal audit every year, and we doing an energy performance track multi compared to the prediction energy performance. And energy team review the energy performance indicator to determine energy performance quarterly. And we do preventive and corrective action is also at the time. The management review we doing every year to see that any change in the energy performance or energy policy, energy performance, objective and target, so on. This is the result that we done that the energy performance is better. This is from the baseline. We using the formula, so we can see that the energy actual and energy prediction in here is fit. So the formula is good enough to predict the energy consumption. So you can see here. After we improve, we doing improvement, and we can see that the gap between energy actual and energy prediction, you can see the gap. The gap is saving that we get. Yeah, so the gap is, so we can get every year, you can see in here. So the saving after doing the project, you can see we have saving 15%, and totally 428,000 gigajoules. So we, in 2015, we get an award from National Energy Award for energy management in the big industry. And 2016, we get award from National Energy Efficiency for the special submission. So 2015 and 2016. And after that, we send the proposal to Energy Management Leadership Board that already explained before, and we get support from the Green Energy Ministry for this Energy Management Leadership Board. I think that's all. Thank you.
Terima kasih, Pak Komisul. Thank you very much. Another very interesting presentation. Again, one award will produce another award. And I think award is not only for the company, but also for the teams. This is to tap to the management that you are doing really good, not you are only declaring that you are good, but somebody else said that you are good. So our third speaker is Ms. Anis Ernani. She is the General Manager of Technology from...
Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the opportunities to me to share a simple best practice in energy management in our company, PT Petrokimia Gresik. Even PT Petrokimia Gresik doesn't implementing a certified energy management, but we do management in energy. Okay, as may you know, Petrokimia Gresik is a state-owned company, and we the most complete fertilizer producer in Indonesia. We produce various kind of fertilizer. Nitrogen fertilizer, phosphate fertilizer, and also compound fertilizer NPK. And also we produce many kind of chemical like ammonia, sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, etc. The Petrokimia Gresik is a member of Pupuk Indonesia working company since 2012, and now we covering the area of our plant 450 hectares in Gresik, Jawa. This slide show us the production capacity of PT Petrokimia Gresik. To show that we have we have 15 fertilizer plant and also 9 non-fertilizer plant, and the capacity of fertilizer is 4.4 million ton per year, and non-fertilizer plant about 3.2 something million ton per year. So the total of production capacity is 7.7 million ton per year. The the plant is, some plant is already eating. So this is the energy consumption is quite high. This slide show the figure of energy consumption, energy source, and the location of energy source in Petrokimia Gresik. So the total energy consumption of PKG per year is about 27 million gigajoule, or equivalent to 650,000 tons of oil equivalent. The most of energy source is come from natural gas and then coal, and the distribution is to the most is for feedstock to produce ammonia and then urea, and steam, electricity, and of course fuel. This is the top management commitment to implement the energy management. So our board is committed to become fertilizer producer, that implementing integrated management system consists of health and safety, process safety, environmental quality management system, and energy management system, halal and food safety management system. At the beginning, we implement the energy management is of course based on the government regulation PP 70/2009, that state energy user consume at least 6,000 kWh per year must conduct energy conservation through energy management, and so far PKG has implemented the appoint energy manager on the organization structure, and then construct the energy conservation program diplomatic energy audit regularly, annual, internal by self audit, and also from external, from audit and ministry. And we also certification of energy manager and energy auditor. Then we implement the energy audit recommendation, and also we report regularly the implementation of energy conservation annually to government regulation. But also we, as a large company, we face the limitation of energy source, and of course energy conservation in plant. What we have done is consists of two major. We just have a solar cell for lighting, but biggest areas, and of course equipment. So the using alternative fuel is based on the calculation of energy cost based on natural gas consumption. So in that figure, the we get that the coal price is GTG we have in plant number one. The load can be decreased from 21 to 17 megawatt, and load in point use the new SDG.
Investment grid audit recommendations, which is conducted by the EMAK to recognize, and I saw some recommendation is there. Part has been executed, part is planning to be there. So I think EMAK, you should be very happy that finally, there is a company who really use your investment grid audit recommendations into action and save a lot of money. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I would like now to open questions and to make the communications more flowing. If you would like to ask in Bahasa, then please you can ask in Bahasa. And also for our speaker, of course, those who can speak Bahasa, please you can also answer in Bahasa, because there is also a translator available here. So just to make sure that we understand your question and you understand our answer. So. Monggo silakan. Ya, satu pertanyaan dari Gusti, silakan.
I have two questions. First for Mr. Koliso. Your presentation about when steam already release the heat, and then it turn phase into the condenser. So you withdraw the condenser at the middle. At the middle of pipe, so it's interesting to me. Why do you not at the bottom? Why do you not put the drain on the bottom for the pipe, but you install it at the middle of the pipe, at the figure bed which you showed to us? And then to Ms. Anis, I appreciate with your presentation, which get award from the Asian Energy Award. And so, because we have the same plan with you, so I want to learn about something, especially at the 173C, with the modified, you change from high pressure steam to medium pressure steam. So, what the modification of the process, or maybe for duration of the step, so the medium pressure steam could be evaporate the steam or the moisture at the dryer. Do you prolong the pressure, or do you prolong the drying time, so the medium pressure could substitute the high pressure steam? Okay, thank you very much for my attention.
Okay, thank you. I will answer in Bahasa ya. Mau isi for us to explain. Terima kasih. Tadi ditanyakan mengenai sistem steam di tempat kami, kenapa pipanya nggak ngambil dari bawah tapi dari tengah. Kira-kira begitu Pak ya. Okay. Jadi untuk paper mesin, itu steam dimasukkan ke dalam dryer. Dryer itu bentuknya silinder, ya, di tengah. Tengah itu shaft. Jadi shaft itu berputar, ya, berputar, sehingga kita nggak mungkin ambil steam dari bawah. Jadi kita ambil steam, ambil air, memasukkan steam, juga melewati shaft, ya, melewati shaft di silinder tadi. Jadi ada pipa yang untuk injeksi steam dari tengah, dan juga ada pipa yang untuk mengevakuasi air dari saturated steam yang terkondensasi melalui tengah shaft tadi. Itu alasannya kenapa tengah. Jadi dengan sistem differential pressure antara inlet sama outlet, seperti kita nyedot lah, menyedot minuman itu. Jadi disedot, jadi menggunakan differential pressure antara inlet dan outlet. Makanya kita perlu atur gapnya di pipa itu sedemikian rupa supaya kita dapatkan DP-nya yang rendah. Kalau gapnya jauh, otomatis kan kita butuh DP yang tinggi. Artinya apa? Itu juga akan menyebabkan steam yang dimasukkan boros, karena ring, water ring, jadi yang cincin air tadi kan juga semakin tebal kalau kita gapnya semakin tinggi. Makanya kalau gapnya kecil, cincin air di dalam dryer itu semakin tipis. Dengan tipisnya air, otomatis kan transfer panas dari dalam keluar itu lebih banyak lah, lebih efisien. Saya kira itu Pak jawabannya. Terima kasih.
Baik, saya kompak dengan Pak Komisi mungkin ya, jadi jawabnya itu bahasa. Apalagi dari saudara sendiri ya maksudnya. Baik Pak, dengan apa namanya mensubstitusi HS air pressure steam ke MS di 173C ini memang ada sedikit apa namanya prolong atau diperpanjang sedikit heating stepnya, tapi secara overall tidak ini Pak, tidak pengaruh banyak ke ini. Jadi tetap bisa apa ya kompak itu antara operasi dan regenerasi, dan kita amati juga dari umur apa molsifnya juga tidak bertambah pendek, artinya berarti apa namanya modifikasi ini atau improvement ini bisa sudah apa, berhasil gitu. Itu ya Pak ya, nanti kalau lebih teknikal lagi kita selesaikan secara adat Pak.
Sorry Pak Harisul, saya mau nambah pertanyaan. Jadi seringkali begini, kita berdiskusi bahwa ada satu action bisa menghemat energi. Saya bapak tadi, karena water yang mau melingkar di cupnya itu berkurang, sehingga steamnya berkurang. Nah ini kadang-kadang perlu kita jelaskan teman-teman. Itu cuma ada duitnya kalau steamnya berkurang, tapi load di boilernya juga di adjust. Kalau steamnya berkurang, tapi jumlah production di generation di steamnya sama saja, ya, tidak menghasilkan duit apa-apa. Nah itu yang suka nggak kompak ini, antara utility sama production. Production sudah bikin banyak project, tapi di boilernya nggak diapa-apain, sama aja nggak menghasilkan saving. Bener nggak sih Pak? Kalau begitu faktanya bahwa ada adjustment juga dari sisi generation. Seperti juga di kasusnya Ibu antara HP dengan MP. Kenapa kok bisa hebatnya sampai sekian banyak? Karena kita nggak perlu bikin steam sampai high pressure, yang kebutuhan gasnya jauh lebih besar daripada MP. Nah kadang-kadang itu memang perlu ditambahkan Pak penjelasannya ini, duitnya dari mana? Where is the money coming from? Where is the beef gitu kan? Pertanyaannya kalau hamburger itu, where is the beef? Monggo, mungkin bisa ditambahkan Pak Polisi dan Ibu.
Benar Pak Aris, bahwa kebutuhan steam yang berkurang harus juga diikuti dengan adjustment di sisi pembangkit. Kita tahu bahwa kalau pembangkit itu supply steam berlebih, juga itu namanya juga pemborosan. Maka kebetulan di tempat kami di power plant PT DSS itu terkoneksi secara monitoring. Jadi dari sisi operasional bisa melihat berapa banyak steam yang dibangkitkan. Sementara dari sisi power plant, mereka juga bisa melihat berapa steam yang dikonsumsi oleh. Jadi ada adjustment, dan ini sebenarnya adjustmentnya itu otomatis sebenarnya, otomatis. Kita punya tadi turbin, gas turbin, cogeneration. Jadi kita punya turbin itu memanfaatkan panas dari pembuangan gas turbin. Jadi dari gas turbin menghasilkan listrik, sisa panasnya dipakai untuk membangkitkan steam. Dan kekurangannya itu disuplai oleh boiler yang dari batu bara. Dan itu ada adjustment secara otomatis, kita tahan pressure-nya tidak terlalu tinggi juga sesuai dengan kebutuhan. Salah satu action yang kita lakukan waktu itu juga, kita semula menggunakan pressure steam itu 8 bar. Ya, 8 bar. Dengan sistem yang lama, kita di mesin itu untuk menghasilkan kertas dengan kadar air 5% untuk berat kertas basis weight, kita sebut berat kertas 70 gram per meter square, itu dengan speed 500 bisa tekanan yang dibutuhkan itu sampai 4,5 bar sampai 5 bar. Setelah kita lakukan optimisasi, maka dengan hasil yang sama, moisture 5%, kita bisa menggunakan steam dengan tekanan yang lebih rendah. Tadinya 4,5 bisa kita turunkan tekanan itu di 2,5 sampai 3 bar. Artinya apa? Bahwa kebutuhan tekanan steam yang semula itu sampai 5 bar, sekarang tinggal 3 bar maksimal. Makanya dari boiler, tekanannya juga diturunkan. Tadinya di 8, kita turunkan menjadi 6 bar. Itu salah satu action yang kita juga lakukan otomatis dengan tekanan yang lebih kecil, nambah konsumsi batu bara yang tadi juga itu juga turun. Terima kasih.
Jadi karena saya dari tadi mendengarkan presentasi, sebenarnya saya ingin tahu itu kan mungkin hasil perhitungan atau hasil dari satu efisiensi dari satu mesin, tapi sebetulnya apakah benar energi yang dipakai oleh whole plant itu memang benar-benar kurang segitu apa tidak? Itu kan itu sebenarnya yang key-nya, karena itu nantinya yang sebetulnya menjadi pencapaian juga ke secara nasional juga, bahwa kita bisa mengurangi berapa kan sebetulnya dari yang real sebetulnya, karena kita tahu bahwa sebetulnya efisiensi energi sebenarnya nggak hanya masalah duit atau berkurangan energi, tapi juga impact ke globalnya, terutama ke CO2 emission misalnya seperti itu kan. Indonesia sudah punya komitmen ya dengan COP21 dan seterusnya, kemudian secara global juga global warming semacam. Nah, itu seperti apa kan seharusnya apa yang kita sampaikan di sini ada konversi ke CO2 emission yang sebetulnya kita bisa contribute berapa. Misalnya seperti tadi ada proyek untuk mengganti sumber energi misalnya, nah, karena lebih murah misalnya. Nah, tapi dari sisi CO2 apakah itu impact-nya lebih tinggi misalnya? Nah, itu mungkin bisa disampaikan juga. Saya lupa tadi yang presentasi ibu atau bapak, saya lupa. Saya cuma mencatat itu saja. Nah, untuk yang ibu dari Ektex ya. I have one question for the Ektex. I don't know if you have another plan in another country or city. So how can you to ensure that the management of energy can be implemented also in your another plants and also maybe in your supplier? So because not only your plant that must be implement the energy management system, actually you have power or you have authority also to push your supplier to implement this one. So do you have any commitment or do you have, your management have a policy about your supplier to implement this energy management system? Thank you.
Now, we don't have plan to implement our supply chain ISO 50001, because we have plan to introduce ISO 50001 to every our company factory. Maybe it takes 5-6 years to complete. So at first, our group company.
Thank you very much. I think Bapak, I think you can discuss also with Yuko Yusuko-chan from Panasonic, because I used to work for Panasonic for 4 years and I know how strong they implement the supply chains. I remember back 2002 or 2004, they obligated all the suppliers also certified 14001. I hope they do the same things for 15001. There will be a very big push for the implementation, because in Indonesia you have at least 13 Panasonic company, they can be the leaders. Bapak nanti silahkan diskusi lebih lanjut dengan teman-teman Panasonic yang sudah punya pengalaman untuk push supply chain. Kemudian Ibu, pertanyaannya adalah ini pertanyaan saya juga sebenarnya bagi kita hubungannya di sini. Ini banyak pabrik semi energi kan? Kemudian klaim berapa juta ton CO2? Pilotnya Yurido hematnya 1,3 juta ton CO2. Pertanyaan saya, pertanyaannya beliau juga, ini nanti kalau ditanya kontribusi ke yang 29% versinya negara yang kok itu bagaimana ya? Saya pikir pertanyaannya bukan ke pabrik itu mas. Kalau beliau-beliau mas sudah hebat ya Bu ya? Sudah kontribusi mas, sudah hebat, kita sama-sama sudah hebat. Tapi saya pikir your question is also our question. How our contributions of CO2 reduction acknowledged by the government when they reported in the climate change UNFCCC that petrochemical Gresik have doing something great, saving the smart ton CO2. And then also IKPP and also maybe Sinarmas Group have doing something great, contribute to the CO2. Because sometimes for this company, recognition of contributions and recognition that they are part of the good citizens is much more important than financial reward. So I don't know, maybe I don't know if this is allowed as moderator, because if this is allowed, I would like to ask Ibu Gita from EMAK to provide us about this race question, please.
Emission reductions, government of Indonesia has committed new emission reductions commitment for the 2030. So in 2030, we are committing 29% of emission reductions. This is for the whole nation, the whole nation. So the from energy, from forestries, also from other sectors. But energy itself, we are committing 314 million tons of CO2 equivalents up until 2013. And how we do this in energy sectors? There are several activities or several programs. One of these is the energy efficiency activities. And where and on how we calculate from energy efficiency. So government already have regulations on energy efficiency, which is the government regulation number 17/2009. So in that regulation, I think from the presentation from EU and MIS, mentioned about in government regulation number 70 that all the company that is consuming from 6,000 DOE until more than that are obligated to do energy conservation programs. So for that company, all the reductions, energy reductions, energy consumption reductions that is reported by that company is actually put into the energy emission reductions targets. So if you, and also from Ibu Ani's presentation that said that currently government has developed what we call OME in Indonesia, which is an online energy management reporting system. And from POMI, if you were, if you can access that, you can see the report is not only on energy reduction, how much energy that you have produced or saved, but also from the emission reductions. So that emission reductions, the number that generated from the reporting system is being claimed by the governments to help governments to achieve the target of 314 million tons.
Thank you. So this is a promotional message from EMAK.
Or if it is exclusively for the big energy users.
I think this is also for me. On what we call the partnerships programs, which is we give free audit for the buildings and industries, and also if they and in the partnership programs they have like an MOU that after after the audit being conducted, you have to report what have you done to implement the audit recommendations. So at least for 2 years, you have to report that to the governments, and government can also plan that for the emission reductions.
So most welcome. This is for the Muslim. This is like what wajib ain and sunnah wakat. Those who 6,000 only must report. Those who are not 6,000 but like to report, then it's great to have you guys.
Can I?
We
really have to say
that. No, 1 or 2 minutes, it will be fine.
Okay. No, because I already answered 2 questions that I can ask. One is that's right, that we want to encourage more company to do reporting. So this year, when I should present it. The next session, but this year, PAN, we want to put that the participants, particularly for the industry, big large industry, they have to done their work first, which is they have to report their energy or do energy conservation first, then they can become a participant in the PAN. That's one. So also supporting Mr. Awang programs. And the second one is questions, actually. So to Bu Anis, come to ISO, 15001. There any plan to implement ISO 15001 to 3 or 5, 10 years?
Ya, memang kita saat ini belum certified ongoing lagi muncul. Jadi sebenarnya tahun kemarin kita sudah juga mengontak, cuman ya ada kendala di perusahaan. Mungkin kita apa namanya balik kata kita mungkin agar segera bisa. Saya rasa mungkin tidak terlalu ini mungkin ya Pak Aris ya, karena kita sudah banyak melakukan ini tinggal bagaimana menggunakannya secara sistem. Kemudian yang kedua Bu, kita memang 2 kali ikut TEN ya. Yang pertama saya lupa yang tahun berapa itu ya, juga di ASEAN Energy Award kita waktu itu hanya sekedar yang awardingnya di Bali saja, itu waktu tahun berapa itu. Kemudian yang kemarin juga tetapi yang saya lihat dari pengamatan kami Bu ya, dari PEN kemarin itu kok yang lebih di apa ya, yang lebih disorot itu terutama di building. Di building dan di office itu padahal kalau dari sisi industri itu tidak banyak, termasuk juga nanti efeknya ke pengurangan apa emisi itu juga mungkin ini ya tidak ini. Jadi bayangan kami mungkin lebih karena mungkin kami mewakili dari industri ya, lebih di kan ke yang tapi sudah bagus sekali pelaksanaannya. Kemudian kita setelah menang di PEN, kemudian kita di Kenjung Star diberikan kayak itu untuk bisa ke ASEAN Energy Award. Saya kira begitu.
terima kasih. Kita tidak lihat juga dua kali kita mengikuti PEN, yang pertama 2015, yang kedua 2016 ya, dengan kategori yang berbeda. Ya, sebenarnya ini adalah untuk memotivasi sister mill di APB Group ya. Kita punya banyak mill sebenarnya, ada di Dapia Serang, Kerawang, ada Bindo Deli di Kerawang, ada Ciri Kimia dan seterusnya. Ya, kita untuk memotivasi teman-teman di sister mill itu untuk ikut juga apa namanya melaksanakan efisiensi energi. Jadi ya secara nasional kita juga ingin apa namanya mengikuti kegiatan atau penghargaan ini, sehingga teman-teman harapannya teman-teman yang di sister mill ikut termotivasi tuanya. Kemudian apa lagi tadi? Kesan. Ya saya kira kegiatan ini juga sangat baik lah untuk mendorong industri-industri maupun gedung-gedung untuk terus meningkatkan efisiensi energi. Jadi penghargaan itu untuk perusahaan yang bisa image perusahaan lah ya, bisa menambah image perusahaan juga bahwa pemerintah bisa mendapatkan apresiasi dari pemerintah tentang kegiatan kita untuk efisiensi energi. Saya kira itu. Untuk masukan yang lain saya pikir sama tadi. Terima kasih.
Baik, saya maaf agak spot-spotan. Kalau konsepnya brand image, maka promotion harus serius dan banyak. Nah, itu yang paling menarik, karena banyak event, award, budgetnya habis di execution award, selectionnya. Tapi lupa menyediakan budget buat promotion setelahnya. Tapi saya lihat SDM sudah sangat bagus, karena kemarin sudah masuk TV gitu kan Bu ya, saya ikutan masuk TV Pak Polisi, ikut interview di Metro TV. Very good lah, jadi saya pikir tinggal lebih dikencengin lagi. Ini kalau industri ada yang curhat, kok kayaknya building itu loh, savingnya paling 1 miliar. Kok promosinya serius banget. Saya yang 45 miliar kok kalem-kalem aja. Mungkin seperti itulah, nanti kita bahas lagi. Karena saya kebetulan ikut bantu SDM juga, sama Bapak Rano juga, untuk bicarakan ke depan gimana supaya lebih baik. Baik, I think we are out of time. Very good presentation. Applause for the speaker. Also, very good response from audience with the question, with the comment. Thank you very much. Mohon maaf kalau ada yang kurang berkenan. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam. Okay. Thank you.
Since 2014, he has been working as an expert and coordinator for the IEE.